Wanna learn how to use calculated fields in your pivot tables? Today, I'll show you how to master them, transforming a simple list into a pivot table with three calculated fields. Let's get started. Imagine you're working at DoorDash and your boss asks you to analyze the performance of three restaurants. From this document, you need to calculate the profit margin for the Pie Chart Pizzeria, Macro Munchies, and Excel Lent Burgers. Why? Because the restaurant with the highest profit margin will be featured as a success story on DoorDash's social media, giving it a huge sales boost. This is a decision you can't take lightly. If business isn't your thing, don't worry. The formula for calculating the profit margin is super simple, and I'll include it here when we get to that part. Besides, the important thing isn't the formula itself, but how we'll use it. With it, you'll learn how to use calculated fields in pivot tables. Ready to start with the pivot table? Select any part of your database and go to the Insert menu. There, choose Pivot Table. Now we're going to tell Excel two things. First, the range of data it should use to create the table. Excel usually selects it for you, but double check to make sure it's correct. Second, specify that you want the table on a separate sheet. Done. To build our pivot table, we just need to drag the fields from our original table to the right places. But which fields and where? We can follow the profit margin formula. Revenue minus total cost, and the result divided by revenue. So the first thing we need is the revenue, right? We already have that field. No need to calculate anything. And since we want to see performance by restaurant, simply put the restaurant in rows and revenue and values. Done, we've got it. Next, we need the total cost, right? The problem is we don't have a total cost field, but we do have the three costs that make it up: ingredients, labor, and operational costs. How do we sum these three values in a pivot table? Easy, with a calculated field. With your pivot table selected, go to the Pivot Table Analyze tab, and in the fields, Items and Sets option, select Calculated Field. A window will pop up allowing you to create calculated fields by simply typing the formulas. First, you need to name your calculated field. We're calculating the total cost, right? Let's call it that. In the box below, you'll see a list of all the fields in your pivot table. To insert a field into your formula, just select it and click Insert Field or simply double-click it. To calculate the total cost, insert the ingredient cost field, then a plus sign, the labor cost, another plus sign, and finally the operational cost. Click OK and voila! You have a new column with the total cost. Before we continue, let's fix the format because my OCD is as strong as the onions in Excel Lent Burgers Hamburgers. First, let's give the fields currency format. Select any value in your revenue column, right-click, and select number format. In the window that appears, select currency and choose how many decimals you want to show. In this case, we don't need any, so put 0. Done! Now, let's change the field names because there's a special place in hell for people who leave the sum of text in calculated fields. Let's overwrite it and just put revenue. When you hit enter, you'll see an error saying there's already another field with the same name, your calculated field. This always happens when you use calculated fields and it's a dumb Excel error, but it's easy to solve. Just add a space at the end of the name, and Excel will take it as different text, so you don't have to come up with new names. Now, let's do the same with the sum of total cost field and call it total cost, adding a space at the end. Now that we have the revenue and costs, we just need to calculate the profit margin, and the process is exactly the same. Let's go back to the calculated fields. We'll name our field profit margin. Then, write the formula. Add the revenue field, then a minus sign. Add the total cost field you calculated before, followed by a division sign, and add the revenue field again. Following basic algebra rules, put the subtraction in parentheses so Excel performs the subtraction first and then divides by the revenue. Click OK and you've got the profit margin, but it looks weird because it doesn't have the right format. Let's fix the field name to profit margin, just remember to add the space at the end. Now, let's format it as a percentage. Select any value in your profit margin column, right-click, and select Format Cells. Choose percentage and indicate how many decimals you want to see. I'll put 0. Now, just press OK and you have all the information you need. Looks like Pie Chart Pizzeria will be the featured restaurant. This is going to sound cheesy, but are you hungry for more pivot tables? You can learn absolutely everything you need to become a master in my course, which you can watch here. See what I did there? Cheesy, haha.